tidings, Kira. It seems that word of the Ultima Weapon's existence has already reached the Alliance leaders in the form of an ultimatum. They have gathered in the Fragrant Chamber and are deliberating their answer even as we speak. Beleaguered as they are, I fear they may well elect to lay down their arms in the belief that surrender will spare their people untold suffering. Yet nothing could be further from the truth. That which the Black Wolf offers will doom Eorzea, not deliver it, and the leaders must be made aware of this. Let us hurry to them, Kira, and ensure that they do not act in ignorance of the consequences.
Ah, we keep treading the same ground!
Van Belsar's demands are clear.
Alas, our minds are not.
I've never been one to shy from a fight, but if this weapon of theirs can do all they claim...
It has been 5 years since the Calamity, and our people have scarce begun to rebuild their lives. Can we now, in good conscience, call upon them to risk what little they have left? I would spare them the pain of further conflict. Conflict, I say, though that would imply forces set in opposition. If the combined might of three primals could not stay Garlemald's new terror, what meaningful resistance can we offer? We who struggle to quell the foes who rise up within our own borders.
Long have we fought the primals, but to what end? We strike them down at no small cost, only for them to rise again and again. Are we to play this profitless game for the rest of days? I, for one, grow tired of it. Mistake me not. I do not propose to trade one tyranny for another. I love liberty. But conciliation need not mean oppression.
By the 12, though neither of you cried surrender, your every word betokened it. Not that I deny there is truth in what you say, nor can I rightly claim that Ul'dah is ready to fight. Refugees flood our gates, and beastmen swarm our land, while the great and the good do nothing. My flames struggle to bear the burden. I put on a grand show at the Remembrance Service, made all manner of lofty promises. I've made good on not a bloody one.
Do not blame yourself, Rauban. You said only that which the people needed to hear. All present have done the same. Our citizens had become lost to hope. If our words serve to kindle it in them anew, better we speak than remain silent. Our enemy condemns us for failing our people. Yet what does he care for their well-being? While we labored to rebuild their lives, the Black Wolf built instruments of murder with which to end them.
Her Majesty speaks true. For all our failings, the people's well-being has ever been our foremost priority. While none among us ever doubted that the Empire would one day resume its war, we scarcely had means enough to solve the problems of the present.
Aye, which is why we look to others to safeguard our future. The Scions of the Seventh Dawn. Alas, they are gone, and the Black Wolf is at our door.
Admiral! I fear you are mistaken.
It's one hell of an entrance.
Alphinord, Minfilia, and Seven Hells, Master Garland?
A And you, dear friend.
By Ralga, you're alive. All of you.
As we approached, I would swear I heard talk of surrender. But I know that cannot be. It is not the Eorzean way.
Hear me, my friends. Accepting the Galleon's offer to vanquish the Primals would be folly. Folly, I say. For might is not the answer to the Primal threat. Indeed, the more the Empire exerts its strength, the worse matters will become. Primals enter this world when mortals call upon them, and mortals are wont to appeal to a higher power when they are desperate. Nothing is more certain to breed desperation in the Beast Tribes than the Galleon's proposed solution.
The true answer lies in a lasting peace, but the Galleons only know war and conquest. Should Eorzea fall into their hands, there will be such suffering as none can imagine.
We are not blind to the many challenges that each of your nations face. Yet you must not give in.
Aye. Remember 5 years ago when you wagered all for the sake of the realm? Remember what you fought for, what you were willing to die for. Let the memories rekindle the fire in your heart, for Eorzea has need of it again.
Come what may, we Scions will never give up the fight. And so I bid you stand with us, and together we shall safeguard the future of the realm.
I love our team. I love them. Scions and Seventh Envoy. We go hard in the paint!
A great man once said that a shrewd merchant grasps not for the quick profit, but invests in the future. Wise words, eh, Rauban?
Cid, I...
Your words stir and shame me in equal measure. How could I contemplate surrender? I know full well that all we have, we owe to the sacrifices of those who went before us. Yet the seeming hopelessness of our plight robbed me of my insight. We Gridanians have no love for war, yet we have still less for those who would threaten our homeland. Ever have we fought to protect those things we hold dear, and this shall never change. Gridania will go to war. We will fight the Empire. For the sake of the realm and all who abide here.
It's crazy, they're the peace lovers, and they're the first one talking about time to go to war.
At long last, I hear words worthy of a founder of the Alliance. Rauban, are we to be outdone?
I lost one homeland. The thought of losing another had blunted my resolve. But no man knows better than I that if you want aught, you'd best be ready to die for it. With great danger comes the chance for great glory and great profit. We old Dons who have turned sand into gold know this well. How many times have we fallen into the pit of despair, only to have you pluck us out? I've fair lost count.
Reckless, the lot of you, like bloody pirates. Well, I won't waste my breath trying to talk you round, on account of being a pirate myself. And the pirate who shrinks from a challenge is no pirate at all. Those who would pick a quarrel with us must choose. Back down, or go down with all hands. Let the Garleans come. The united strength of Limsa Lominsa will be waiting for them.
If our realm is to be free of this pall of darkness, let it be by our own hands.
For Eorzea!
We must needs consider how the weapon may be brought to bear against us.
The Maelstrom will secure strategic points along the coastline.
In the meantime, the flames will deploy at...
Be at ease, my friends. You have banished our doubts. Pray leave the military matters to us and retire to the Waking Sands. We will send word anon.
Feels good to be back. Hey, got new members. Oh, look who it is, Lafswiss. My dear sister drew her last breath here. Battle with the Empire. To her, the fight for Eorzea's future was more important than her homeland. True to her beliefs to the end, she was. Alf, no matter how dark the night, one day the dawn will break. As long as the brave souls like yourself take up our cause, the Scions will never stand down. Though our losses weigh heavy in our hearts, let's carry on for those who have fallen. I should have done something, done anything, but I didn't. And now Aaba, Dalu, Ali, I will not let it be for nothing. I will earn this. It's so good to be back! Instead of gratitude for coming to his rescue, Papalimo called me a scatterbrain. The next time he gets caught by the Emperor, I'm leaving him to rot. Stolen. We may have surmounted this latest trial, but the worst is yet to come. We must remain focused. I will not see our efforts wasted in futile regret. And as for Thancred, he and I have much to discuss. You and me both, sister. The counteroffensive to come will require the total commitment of every allied nation, as well as the flawless coordination of all forces. I pray the council understands this. Dr. Root, don't be singing. I understand you gave our fallen brothers and sisters a proper burial. I'm sure they appreciated it. When the Empire is beaten and all of this is over, let us visit them at the church. Cid, my boy. For many years, I dedicated my life to the research and development of Magitek, unable or unwilling to see the repercussions of my work. And though I have since left Garland World behind, its scientists continue to build upon my work. I fear that this new weapon may be another example of that, an ancient relic enhanced with technologies I created. Yet even should that be the case, it would still require a brilliant mind to... No, he didn't. Be talking about dude in red armor. What's next on the agenda? We're ready to get to work. She hasn't said a word to me since the rescue. Is it all for nothing? Hell yeah. She saw me. She sees a sword. She saw me putting in that work. She's not my type.
I cannot well express my relief. To think that the Alliance came so close to surrender.
But the fire in their hearts has been rekindled, and they will fight to the last.
This warmth inside. Did you feel it too, Grandfather? I would know something. Was that your power at work earlier?
Nothing of the sort. The leaders of Eorzea had lost their way. I merely helped them to find it again. Oh, hello. Yes, our party returned just a moment ago. How close are you? It's all right, Cid.
We must needs plan our next move. Pray continue liaising with your respective nations. Cid, would you be our man in Ul'dah?
I'll be whatever and wherever you need me to be.
I need you to be a hole on the corner. Just kidding.
We haven't a moment to waste.
All right, let's do this.
Thancred's fate weighs heavy on my mind. I cannot bear to think of him enthralled to an Assian. Mayhap you know this already, but the Assians are immortal beings without physical form. Since time immemorial, they have fanned the flames of chaos from the shadows. That they might work unseen, the Assians entrap and possess mortal men by means of malign artifacts known as Crystals of Darkness. One such crystal may yet be the key to saving Thancred.
This is a crystal of darkness.
A mere replica, created using data obtained from anomalous crystals found across Eorzea.
It comes to us courtesy of the students of Baldessian, our distant allies. Even for an Archon, Thancred's talents are exceptional. We all had complete confidence in him. It was for this reason that none among us foresaw the danger in sending him to investigate the Assians alone.
Thancred had been striving to fill the void left by Louissois. Yet, it was plain that he was overtaxing himself.
Yeah, he would volunteer for everything and work till he was dizzy.
And the toll taken by his exertions made him vulnerable to Assian influence.
The crystal that binds Thancred must be somewhere on his person. If we could but destroy it, his Assian possessor would be compelled to relinquish control over him. You have proven the stoutest of allies, standing with us through thick and thin. Yet the most perilous struggle is still to come. For the sake of the realm, and Thancred, I ask that you lend us your strength once more. Thank you, from the bottom of my heart. As I am sure you are aware, the realm was saved from certain doom 5 years ago by heroes known as the Warriors of Light. What you may not be aware of is that your many feats in service to the Scions have prompted folk to make certain comparisons. I must confess, you do remind me of them. Yet remember this, however glorious the past, it is the hero's lot to be judged on the deeds of the present. A new darkness threatens the realm, and the people cry out for a savior. I believe that you are she, a warrior of light, here in the present, guided by the crystal's will. Come, my friends, let us fight to safeguard the future of our beloved Eorzea.
All present, then let us begin. We've received the details of the impending operation. And what promises to be the largest single counteroffensive in the realm's troubled history, the Alliance will strike at every Imperial stronghold standing upon Eorzea's soil. As might be expected, the operation will be complex, but you need not commit its intricacies to memory. It is enough for each man to understand his part and plays it to the best of his ability. The finer instructions you will receive at each staging point. To begin, let us review the distribution of our forces. From west to east, the Maelstrom of Limsa Lamensa, the Immortal Flames of Ulda, and the Order of the Twin Adder of Gridania. West to east. Next, let us examine the locations of the Imperial strongholds. Near Limsa Lamensa, we have Castrum Occidens, situated in eastern Vilbrin, and Castrum Marinum, which lies to the south and east in the midst of the Rotano Sea. Near Uda, we have Castrum Meridianum to the north and the coastal outpost at Cape Westwind, which connects Castrum Meridianum to the mainland by means of Magitek Transporter. Near Gridania, we have Castrum Oriens, which lies upon the eastern edge of the Twelve's Wood. And finally, in Mordona, stands Castrum Sentry, a thorn in the heart of Eorzea. The forthcoming operation will see Allied forces assault each of the aforementioned locations, with the ultimate objective of destroying the Empire's new weapon, housed within Castrum Meridianum. As one might expect of the Black Wolf's seat of power, Castrum Meridianum boasts all but impenetrable defenses. If we are to breach it, we must needs isolate it from its sister strongholds. To do otherwise would be to risk being caught twixt hammer and anvil. The operation will compromise four distinct phases all told. The first shall see us eliminate one of the Black Wolf's most trusted tenants, Retatin Sas Arvina. According to our intelligence, the Prefectus is due to visit the Imperial outpost at Cape Westwind for an inspection. When he arrives, we shall dispatch an elite adventurer unit to eliminate him. Here, we would have you lead this assault. Retatin is a peerless field tactician. Shorn of his leadership, the garrison at Castrum Occidens will be as a snake without its head. Phase 2 will see us sever Castrum Meridianum's primary lines of supply. As soon as Retatin's presence is confirmed at the coastal outpost, the Maelstrom will lay siege to Castrum Occidens. At that very hour, the Lemensan Armada, helmed by the Admiral herself, shall move to blockade Castrum Marinum. Meanwhile, in the Twelve's Wood, the Order of the Twin Adder will surround Castrum Oriens. And we'll have the Sylphs to help them, Frixio's been waiting for a chance to avenge these ones. She's using their words. Phase 3 shall see a neutralize of Castrum Meridianum's defenses. Forming our main thrust, the Immortal Flames will march against the stronghold with all their strength. While the enemy's eyes are thus drawn outwards, another elite adventurer unit shall infiltrate the Castrum. Its mission? To disable the Magitek field generator which protects the Praetorium, a fortress within a fortress wherein the ultimate weapon is believed to be housed. Kiera would have you take command once more. Easy breezy. Meanwhile, the Order of the Twin Adder will blockade the railway which connects Sentry and Meridianum, preventing the timely arrival of reinforcements from Mordona. A wise precaution. The monstrous locomotive which runs back and forth between the two castra is capacious enough to transport a small army by all accounts.
Capacious.
It is well the Garleans did not think to give it wings.
Doom train anybody?
Once Marianum's defenses have been compromised, operation will enter into fourth and final phase. Kira's going in like a boss. You'll see the mortal flames enter the stronghold and suppress the remnants of the enemy garrison, allowing Kira's unit to pass unopposed into the Praetorium, where they will locate and destroy the ultimate weapon.
Oh!
I'm doing my Cloudbuster sword swing right now. In addition to the Grand Companies, we can count upon the support of a variety of other parties, from the Pirates of Lensa Limsa to the Monetarists of Ulda. In all, the operation will involve no fewer than 12 major factions. Legend holds that the Archons were 12-1, and 1-12. It is for this reason that our grand endeavor has been dubbed Operation Archon. Countless free companies have also pledged their swords, and more join us by the day. At long last, all of Eorzea is rising as one, other than freaking Ishgard. As before, we shall work in concert with the grand companies. Ida, Papalima, Yashtola, pray, accompany your respective organizations on their missions. Orianche, I would have you represent us in Ulda. Reassure the financiers that they have made a sound investment. When that is done, pray return here and aid in the coordination of our forces. Tataru, please assist Orianje in any way you are able, and ensure that everyone is kept abreast of the latest developments. And Philia, Cid, and I shall accompany the main host in an advisory capacity. It will be our task to analyze intelligence as it comes into our possession, and make the necessary recommendations to command. As Alphanol mentioned, you are to lead the elite unit of adventurers whose task will be to see each of Operation Archon's main objectives fulfilled. Yours is the most important role of all, and like to be the most dangerous. Pray, choose your party well, and stint not in your preparation. Got it. The battle of the future of the realm is about to begin. Together, let us show the Black Wolf the power of a united Eorzea.
Yeah!
It's go time, son. Pray report to the Immortal Flames encampment situated to the north of here when you are ready to be briefed on your first mission.
Oh, I'm ready.
I cannot stress this enough, but please be careful. May you walk in the light of the crystal.
Yes, ma'am.
You are welcome, Kira Mercer of the Scions. As communications officer, it falls to me to issue your orders and provide guidance on forthcoming missions. Your first mission is to infiltrate the Imperial outpost at Cape Westwind and eliminate Prefectus Ritaten Sas Arvina. All participating units are now in position and awaiting your arrival. Please proceed to the staging point and report to Lieutenant Adalbert. This is but the first step in our bid to purge the realm of the Garlean menace. I shall pray for your success. So you're Kira Mercer, the fearless adventurer who's to lead the assault. We've been expecting you. Our Maelstrom friends report that Taten Sas Arvina departed Castrum Ocidens a bell ago. And sure enough, a convoy of Imperial airships landed here just now. The likelihood is high that our target was aboard one of the vessels. I've dispatched scouts to verify his presence before we strike. Command all units requesting status report. This is Antiline. Antiline 1. target has not been sighted. The Antiline too. Likewise, target has not been sighted. Antiline 3 here. We've got nothing for you neither. This is Antiline 4. Nothing to port as of... Wait, disregard previous message. Target sighted. I say again, target sighted. Understood. Hold your position. Attention all units. This is Lieutenant Adelbert Cotter. First step of Operation Archon begins with us. Should we falter here, all hope of victory will be lost. Just no small burden, but know that I believe in all of you. So believe in yourselves, and together we will blaze a path for our brothers and sisters of the Alliance to follow. We'll create multiple diversions and disperse the enemy garrison. That should give your people a chance to breach the defenses. Go now, Kieran, bring us Titan's head. May Rolger grant you strength. Everybody's so killer instinct around here. Commence diversionary maneuvers. But it appears we have unexpected guests. Now, where have I seen you before? Ah, but of course, the woman who failed the mighty Titan. It's the Icon Slayer? I see. The commotion without is not but a diversion. Allow me to hazard a guess. By eliminating me, you hope to undermine the garrison of Occidents. Bold strategy, to be sure. Have you the strength to see it to fruition? Leave us. None of you are a match for her. Send word to Castrum Occidents. Tell them the Lamentians are coming. At once, my lord. Years have come and gone since Lord Van Bowser first set foot in Eorzea, yet his ambition for the realm burns as strong as ever it did. Know you what fuels an adventurer? The desire to deliver the people from their suffering. The lands he has conquered were all beset with problems, poverty, starvation, lawlessness, and strife. My homeland was no exception. Had my lord not reached out and claimed it for the Empire, it would eventually have destroyed itself. But under his sage leadership, my people enjoyed such peace and stability as we had never known. And he only desires the self-same for the people of this realm. Under his rule, Eorzea would be free from the shackles which bind it, the shackles of false faith. There would be no feeble leaders to misguide the masses, no icons to bleed the realm dry. True peace would reign. People would be free to live their lives without fear of persecution or oppression. Should you doubt the truth of my words, I bid you look upon me. I am no son of Garlemald, yet Lord Van Bowser so fit to raise me to station of great honor. He measures a man not by his birth, but by his worth. Such is his sense of justice. By the grace of his excellency, I am where I was born to be, upon the field of battle. He has given me a noble cause to fight for, and worthy adversaries to smite. I am not wont to bear my steel needlessly, but if you are deaf to reason...
I am, motherfucker! In the name of Lord Van Bowser, I, Retantin Sazarvina, do swear to strike you down.
Let's do this.
Transporter. Kira, are you there? What news of Ratatin? Fallen? With this deed, you have sown the seeds of our ultimate victory. Fading of that light presages an end to the Empire's tyranny. Ratatin Sas Arvina is no more. But the next phase of Operation Archon commence. Tisai, seems you've done it again, Kira. I'd raise a tanker to you. I'm afraid we've no time to savor the victory. There's still a small matter of infiltrating Castrum Meridianum and destroying the ultimate weapon. I know, no rest for the preternaturally gifted. Now stop feeling sorry for yourself and make your way back to the Immortal Flames encampment. Communications officer will issue you your orders. I'll be waiting for you with the main host. Third. Bringing the light. Alas, the gate to the void already stands open. Soon, darkness shall consume all, and you shall bow down before the one true God. Prefectus? Slain? Readily so, my lord, and at the hand of the Icon Slayer. The centurion who survived the attack is to be believed. Tutton! Where were his men when he faced the enemy? Fleeing even as their commander yielded up his last breath? If it should prove they questioned his right. I cannot speak for them, my lord. Pardons, my lord, but there's more. The Maelstrom had laid siege to Castrum Occidens. Likewise, the Crimson Fleet moves to blockade Castrum Meridianum. So this is their answer. Very well. Shall crush them as we crush the Icons. Go forth and show them the futility of their resistance. Yes, my lord. Yes, your highness. Sion Mercer. Deeds this day are an inspiration to us all. The death of the Prefectus, Operation... The death of the Prefectus, Operation Archon, has entered its second phase. Even as we speak, the Maelstrom moves to blockade Castrum Occidens and Castrum Meridianum. And far to the east, in the Black Shroud, the Word of the Twin Adder advances upon Castrum Moriens. Already, you have done much to advance our cause, performing such feats as are worthy of song. But if our plan is to succeed, more is required of you. Let me know when the preparations are in order, and I shall relay to you the particulars of your next mission.